Hi, Sam Bell here, and today I'm going to be doing a demo and review of the Tosin Abasi TAM100 model signature Ibanez 8-string guitar, which was really kindly lent to us by Nevada Music. I'm going to take you through some of the specs of this really kind of special looking guitar, definitely of all the hardware. So let's start from the headstock end. We've got gold hardware, as you can see. We've got Gotto tuners, which are regular tuners that you get on the normal Prestige models with pearl heads. We've got locking tuners, like I just said. And then we've got this lovely neck, which is made out of Wenge, and Bubinga. I can't tell if I'm pronouncing that right. If you want to check the Ibanez website for the exact name of that. It does sound very good though with the pickups. We've got pearl inlays, and it goes all the way up here, and we've got this lovely maple top with this kind of finish, and we've got a gold edge 3/8 hardtail bridge. Okay, so it looks like a floating trem, but it's not. It's directly bolted into the body, really good sustain, and because of the locking tuners you can get some really nice sort of microtonal tweaks there when you're tuning it up to make sure it's perfectly in tune. We've got lots of options in terms of switching with this guitar. We've got the volume and a tone, and we've got a five-way switch and plus a coil tap option. I'm going to take you through those sounds in a moment. One thing I might just mention, this is a 27-inch scale length 8-string, which is a really nice, it's a bit longer than your regular 6 or 7-string guitar. Just helps those lower notes resonate a little bit better. Okay, I'm just going to turn it over now so you can see what the back of it looks like. So there you can see the different woods in the neck, all of them kind of entwined there. Sounds really nice with the the DiMarzio ionizer pickups. And it's got titanium reinforcement, so it's really solid, sturdy neck. As you can see there. And also the horn here has been cut away slightly so you can get a better access to the higher frets. Okay, now I'm going to go through some clean tones whilst just playing through the different pickup selections so you can really hear the tonal variety of this instrument. It's quite impressive. Okay, so we're going to go through the pickup selectors. We're going to go from the bridge pickup in humbucking mode. This switch here is the coil tap switch. Don't know if you can see that. That's turned off at the moment, so we're going to have a full humbucker sound. Let's hear how that sounds. Okay, now we're going to go into the middle and bridge splits. So we've got these two pickups working now. Right, so now let's try the middle pickup. Now the fourth position is the middle and the closest to the neck. And finally, the neck pickup in humbucking mode. Okay, now I'm going to turn this coil tap feature on. And this means, it doesn't affect the other pickups, but it does affect the pickups when they're in neck and bridge mode. So at the moment, we're going to go to bridge, the coil tap is on, and you're going to just hear this pickup here. It's going to sound a bit different. Okay, so coil tap on, that was the bridge, now the neck. So as you can see there, there's lots and lots of different options for your kind of tone. And that was just of a clean tone, so you can really hear the details and the sound. Tosin Abasi himself in the band Animals as leaders uses a lot of layering of different clean parts as well. So it's probably very useful to have texturally when you're recording and producing a song. So let's have a listen to this guitar now with the bridge pickup with the coil tap off for some heavier rhythm stuff. We'll be right back. Okay, now I'm going to go to the neck pickup and we're going to try some leads. So we've heard the neck and the ridge of distortion. Now I'm going to go to the position with these two pickups just so you can hear how you can still hear the twanginess through the distortion. This is something Tosin does a lot with his distorted tones. Okay, so there you can hear a really kind of raspy, kind of open kind of sound. It's really quite unique, especially it's very prominent of these pickups, the DiMarzio ionizers, and this neck wood. It really makes a unique kind of combination of tone. So yeah, I think it's a very solid 8-string guitar. I think that with time, with Tosin's influence on guitar and music, I think maybe this guitar, if he keeps on working hard, could be up there with the gem and the universe. It's definitely got Tosin's personality within the build. So go down to your local music store and check one out.